Not too long ago, we moved to our new 100-year-old house in the woods, and we were aiming to bring wabi-sabi design elements to create a rustic yet modern home that fit our lifestyle. This is what we took into consideration when trying to balance wabi-sabi with our modern lifestyle. First off, what is wabi-sabi? Wabi-sabi is a part of Japanese aesthetics and philosophy that focuses on the appreciation of imperfection and impermanence. Although wabi-sabi has become a way of looking at life, you can create a wabi-sabi home and also a wabi-sabi garden, which I'll focus on in another video. Appreciating the simplicity and beauty of things that are not perfect is the key to designing your wabi-sabi home. Author Richard Powell sums it up as, "Wabi-sabi nurtures all that is authentic by acknowledging three simple realities. Nothing lasts, nothing is finished, and nothing is perfect." So let's talk about a wabi-sabi lifestyle. We need to first understand the notion of abandoning perfect and seeing the beauty in original and unique items. It is a subtle elegance and sophistication that is done confidently in a non-flashy way. At Shizen Style, we like to think of this as the perfect blend between natural and contemporary. It's not purely minimalistic without function, and it's not sterile without beauty, but it is a lifestyle that allows you to get rid of the non-essential items and focus on and highlight the authentic and original aspects that define your life and who you are. So what does wabi-sabi mean? The root word wabi technically has the connotations of poor or poverty, but also taken out of the meaning of simple and humble. In this case, being poor is not seen as being dependent on material things like clothes, but also wealth and power. Sabi technically means to rust or weather, but now has the meaning of aged and tranquil, referring to the calmness and beauty that comes with something naturally taking form over time. Zen Buddhism has taken these original meanings and shaped them into the concept of the beauty of imperfection and inevitable and beautiful decay of things over time. Here's where I start when thinking about bringing the concept of wabi-sabi into my home. In order for this ancient Zen philosophy to become part of our modern daily lives, we need to first allow ourselves the room to change and begin to embrace the little things in life that make up our long-lasting memories. Whether you have a farmhouse-style house, a mid-century modern, or a sleek contemporary house, there is room for wabi-sabi to be a part of your home. How you balance the rustic and modern is half the fun in creating this timeless design style. Although terms like wabi-sabi can be thought of as trendy, we have to remember that this has been a Zen concept for living for many decades in Japan. It's a way of decorating the home. It can be a way of designing a garden. And ultimately, it can become a lifestyle that allows you to appreciate the beauty of everything, especially the unique and imperfect. Decluttering. First, I think we can start with thinking of the concept of minimalism and getting rid of the extra clutter that we just don't need. Now, I'm not actually a huge proponent of pure minimalism because I don't think it's a realistic goal for our modern lifestyles that involve families and other people we live with. But if you aren't using an item regularly and you have storage for it, I think it should be put away somewhere else. But it might be a good time to evaluate whether that item really serves any purpose anymore. There really is a good feeling when you can eliminate the extra things that you have that are basically baggage. It allows you to focus on the fewer things that you do to keep or highlight, and you'll eventually appreciate them more. The next thing I like to think of is seasonality. You may want to only keep out and highlight items that are in season. I don't mean just focusing on an upcoming holiday, but more about what flowers or trees are in season. choosing to keep certain color vases that would bring out the beauty of the current season is a nice way of keeping those items or putting them away when not in season. Think about making your space a nice backdrop for changing items in your house to reflect the current season. The more windows that you have will directly allow you to bring the season inside as well. Showing an appreciation for the current season shows that you're focusing on the moment, which is a big part of wabi-sabi. Aiming for handmade. Author Andrew Juniper has said that if an object or expression can bring about within us a sense of serene melancholy and a spiritual longing, then that object could be said to be wabi-sabi. Part of the beauty of wabi-sabi is to appreciate things as they are, which usually means there is some imperfection. When searching out items for your home, a great place to start is by looking through handmade items that could act as an accent piece. Having something authentic, meaning there's no two exactly the same, allows you to begin to appreciate the small differences in things. It also is a path to appreciating hard work and recognizing someone else's passion that was put into an item. When you think about something that has been handmade or created by someone, you're more likely to take care of it by way of appreciation. Although you can have certain themes or an overall color scheme when thinking about designing a room, you rarely find perfectly matching furniture if you're looking for wabi-sabi. It is easier to focus on certain colors or textures in the home instead of trying to organize a modern, shiny look. So there's a mindset change that needs to take place in order to begin to appreciate wabi-sabi. And that comes from learning to appreciate those imperfections instead of searching for perfect. Shiny new object syndrome. I'm not suggesting that we all need to take up residence in a hermitage or abandon everything and live in a hut in the woods, but as this mindset starts to set in, you should find yourself looking more for original rustic items as opposed to following the latest trend. Design trends come and go, and when the gods decide this year's trendy color scheme, it's completely opposite from last year. So you'll quickly see that you'll be wasting a lot of time keeping up with the Joneses. This can be a good source of inspiration sometimes, but it does often run against or contradict the wabi-sabi lifestyle and mindset. Even if you have a newer modern house with a somewhat sleek interior, you can begin to add certain items that are withered and aged. In contrast, it can be a very beautiful thing and is something we've come to embrace as Shizen style. This is the whole concept of our modern rustic home and garden lifestyle, blending the contemporary and new with aged and rustic, allows you to contrast and better appreciate both styles. Wabi-sabi fashion. One important point I want to make is that rustic doesn't have to be dirty. In terms of fashion, wabi-sabi would relate to something that has meaning for you and could be compared to a warm pair of boots or broken-in leather jacket. Yes, you can buy these items that look old and worn, but what I'm suggesting is you keep that item and you break it in yourself, and over time, as it begins to age, your memories with a particular item will also begin to develop. This comes back to the idea of buying quality, not quantity. Certain spots or stains on a pair of leather boots or scuffs on a jacket may conjure up images of a particular time that something might have happened. Being able to have a nostalgic bond with a certain item will allow you to naturally appreciate that item more. Seeing that item with memories attached, hanging up, or on a display will essentially become a part of your interior design. So what color is wabi-sabi? It's very easy and tempting to think that wabi-sabi equals dark earth tones, but there really is a lot of subjectivity here. Although the whole house and the different rooms within them will flow better with an inspiration from nature, you have to remember that there are a lot of colors in nature. green may very well be the dominant color, with everything from bright green grass to dark green pine forest. But you have to think about the overall mood you're trying to create in the room. We did our guest room in this very light green-gray combination. With the large picture windows viewing the surrounding forest we added in, it softens the green textures and creates a clean and comfy feeling. The gray and brown bamboo flooring also creates a solid earth-toned base as well, anchoring the modern wabi-sabi theme. But spring and Easter time have a lot of pastel and bright colors, and cherry blossom pinks fall on a wide variety of the pink scale. If these are the type of colors you're drawn to, don't worry, they're also a part of nature. It's all about balance and using those pops of color wisely. We sometimes say beauty lies in the eyes of the beholder, but in Japan, the concept of beauty and the word for beautiful come from a different place. Utsukushi is the Japanese word for beautiful, but its original meaning means something that has been loved. This shows the connection to appreciation and beauty in things that are worn and have been with us for a while. An old cabinet or bookshelf that is soft around the edges and worn out can be considered a thing of beauty if highlighted that way. It is the concept of seeing things as beautiful that have been loved. This is a feeling we had when we moved to our new house. It was built in 1920 and has had the same owners for a very long time. We could see and feel that they had taken care of the house, and there was something beautiful about that. We could see the beauty in sort of carrying on the tradition, but in our own way. It definitely needed some updating and adding some contemporary elements and appliances to the space, but this only let us highlight the history and special naturally worn areas. It took us 8 months to get internet across the bridge. We gutted the kitchen and opened a few walls up to connect to the space better. But in general, we were trying to both preserve the beauty of the lived-in space as we fit it into our modern needs and Shizen's style of blending modern and natural styles. Wabi-sabi pottery and kintsugi. Traditionally in Japan, Senno Rikyu developed the concept of wabi-sabi through tea ceremony. He had a high appreciation for natural earthenware that has become a large part of the tea ceremony, which is taking the time to observe and appreciate teacups and bowls that hold the tea, as well as the tea itself. A 14th century shogun is also attributed to a related concept of kintsugi. One time, he had a very prized and expensive piece of pottery that needed to be repaired. After it came back to him with a bad repair job, he brought it to a master craftsman who repaired it with gold in the seams and up the cracks. This reinforces the philosophy of not merely throwing something away because it's old, unfunctional, or broken down looking. Sometimes repairing something using new techniques or new materials blended with the materials can bring about a deeper and new appreciation for an item. This can be seen in some TV shows about refurbishing old antiques, and it is taking something that is worn out and beaten down and adding something new to it that brings it back to life. Kintsugi encourages you to embrace the flaws and even highlight the flaws, which only stand to strengthen the originality. With beautifully repaired cracks in a vase or newly painted table legs, leaving the top surface rough, you're creating something that is now original to you and both highlighting it, its beauty, along with its new additions. So the essence of this philosophy is repair something, don't replace it. You may just find a new unexpected beauty in something that was almost forgotten, but can now also be seen in a new light. Shizen is another Japanese concept of nature and naturalness, and is what we draw our name Shizen style from. It is blending the wabi-sabi concept and natural Shizen to create a lifestyle where the modern and the rustic coincide together beautifully. Please subscribe and continue watching one of my many other videos on Japanese aesthetics for your home, garden, and lifestyle, because they guide you to leading a happy, comfy, and intriguing life full of curiosity and creativity.